I'm aiming for Christmas in Aho, but obviously likelihood is slim, right? It's gonna be really hard for me to get the, oh my gosh, oh! It's gonna be really hard for me to get Christmas in Aho, and I spoke too soon. How's it going, my dudes? Welcome back to another video. Do anyone even remember the time when I got Christmas in Aho? I sure don't. Okay, this makes me a little bit sad because I was so excited to get Christmas in Aho, and I'm still very happy that I got her several times, but I have not even showcased her since then. So we're gonna do that today, and in fact, I'm gonna show you how to use Christmas in Aho to create a permanent fever team. So you might be asking, what's the difference between a fever team and a permanent fever team? Basically, they both aim to have the same objective, which is constant fever, right? But in a typical fever team, unfortunately, it is very difficult for you to achieve a permanent fever team. And the reason why you want to achieve a permanent fever team instead of just, you know, building back the fever meter again is, if you watch the video at the top, I've already explained that the fever bar gets harder and harder to fill up and therefore less efficient. So as soon as your fever actually depletes to zero, you can be very sure that you're not going to get it to permanent fever again. Because if you fail the first time, it's going to be harder for you to succeed the second time or the third time onwards. Now with that out of the way, let's take a look at what Christmas in Aho can do. Now, just a slight flex over there. Okay, her skill, Shirano tosses presents from the Yokai Slay, restoring the HP of all parties. Effect booster for light units, increases fever gauge by, okay, I'm pretty sure that it's 100, I could be wrong here. Skill gauge of 500, pretty high. And let's take a look at the leader, Vulpine, a skill is activated by light units, you add 50 to fever gauge, and you add 30% to attack for light units. Now let's take a look at ability. Ability number 1, 15% to attack for light units, this is very minor. Ability number 2, this is what's quite important for her kit, which is whenever HP is recovered, you add 30 to fever gauge. So as long as she gets healed, she adds 30 to your fever gauge, and that includes recovery skills, which is very important for this build. And her main, whenever a skill is activated by light units, you add 50 to fever gauge. So whenever a unit uses a skill, including herself, you actually immediately add 50, and if you use a recovery skill, you add 50 first, and then every single proc of the heal adds 30 to the fever gauge. And of course, ability number 4 is basically just the administrator book. Now, our discussion is not complete without talking about Neph team. Okay, Neph team is going to be super important. Let's take a look at why. Let's take a look at a leader skill over here. This is the reason why we're using her, okay? Guiding Star plus, plus 40% to attack for light units, which is actually kind of low, but not a problem. The next one is the important one, plus 30% to fever mode time. Okay, so the reason why this character is so important is because she actually adds up to 50% of fever mode time. Now, lengthening the fever mode duration is super important because your characters generally have super high skill gauges, and you will need a lot of time to maintain the fever gauge so that you can build up enough skill gauge to drop more skills and therefore replenish the fever gauge. So it is not possible to just use a lot of recovery skills. It is simply not enough. You need Neph team. Okay, so ability number 1, you add 20% of fever mode time, therefore you get 50%. Ability number 2, you add 25% to damage against broken or down foes for this unit. During a fever, you actually have a chance to down the boss via normal attacks, via skills, whatever. Even your summon multi-bombs can actually down the boss as well. So when the boss is down, he actually takes in 1.5 times damage, which is gonna be where the bulk of our DPS is gonna come from, downing the boss and doing more damage that way. And also, her main ability number 3, while in fever mode, you add 54% to attack 4 light units. And also, whenever you recover HP, you add another 22 to the fever gauge, very similar to what Christmas in Aho can do. As you can see, we have Razelt, we have Corina, we have Caillou. These three units are all recovery units. Razelt is not exactly the most perfect recovery unit because his skill gauge is rather high. However, he makes up for it with a lot of attack power. So let's quickly just take a look at Razelt's abilities over here. While the HP of another unit is above 80%, you add 60% to the attack for that unit. And also, every 10 times Razelt takes damage, he actually adds 30% attack to the party. It comes as an attack buff. And as you can see, we are also including Murakumo here because you actually have a 600% additional chance to down the enemy. And of course, this only happens during fever. So Murakumo is an excellent choice to use in a light fever team. And the discussion is not complete without suggesting why we are using Corina and Caillou. Okay, Corina could be quite straightforward because if you take a look at her ability number 2, whenever HP is recovered by light units, you add 1.75% to attack for that unit, caps out at 17.5%, which seems super straightforward. But actually, this is not the reason why we're using her. Okay, so the reason why we are using Corina is because she has the second best recovery to skill gauge ratio. So she actually heals 5 procs of HP with a skill gauge of 430. The most efficient healer in the game right now is Dorothea. She has, I think, a skill gauge of 340 if I'm not wrong. for 5 ticks of heal. However, Dorothea does do 20% damage to all your allies when she uses that skill as well. So there's going to be a little bit of juggling of HP. I don't want to have that because I'm using Razelle. Razelle needs to be topped up all the time. Now, Kaiyu is going to be the second best regeneration ratio unit. She does add extra attack, and while she does debuff your allies with negative resistance, that's where Razelle comes in to clear off that debuff. As you can see, my objective is to ensure that the skill gauges of unit 1 and unit 2 are pretty similar, because I'm going to be giving Christmas Inaho the Prismatic Dual Blades, which gives her an additional 40% to skill gauge at the start. I'm doing this so that I can stagger unit 1 and unit 2. There is always going to be this constant juggling between unit 1 and unit 2, and therefore, this actually helps to upkeep my fever a lot. This is very important. You need to segregate your units. So you're either going to do it manually, or you have to give one of them more skill gauge at the start. So this is enough talking. Let's take a look at the run. We are going to be testing on the Cocoa Bird because the Cocoa Bird has a lot of HP. And I just realized that sounds like Cuckoo Bird, but you don't need to know what that means. So the duration of the run is going to give us enough evidence whether or not the team works. As long as we're able to upkeep the fever for a very long period of time, we can be sure that it is fully functional and it is reliable. So do take note that we have to run this on solo. We can't actually bring Light Fever into a team fight unless the rest of the other two players are also running Light Fever, and they must be able to maintain fever on their own. So as you can see, we just entered fever with our second unit, Christmas Inaho, with that 40% skill gauge. And then now we are able to stagger our skills and maintain fever up high. So as you can see, now that we are depleting our fever, it is slightly maintained by our recovery skills. But before fever actually depletes to zero, our Christmas Inaho actually moves, therefore pushing our fever up again. That is really awesome to see. And this will just keep continuing, right? As you can see over here, our fever is going a little bit lower. But hey, Neph Team actually moves. So anytime right now, and there we go, Neph Team goes. Our fever is slowly replenishing because we have Corina giving us that recovery. And then our Razelle moves with even more recovery, so our fever gauge is actually boosting a lot. Now, another thing about having Neph Team as a leader, we have 50% additional fever gauge duration, which kind of means that all the fever gauge boost that we have, let's say Neph Team and Christmas Inaho gets healed, they will boost the fever gauge for us, right? But with that 50% fever gauge duration boost, we can think of this fever gauge gain as 50% increased as well. So we are just about to defeat the Cuckoo Bird over here, but our fever is still maintained pretty well. In fact, we are not even depleting, and we are not even like getting anywhere close to losing our fever at all. So I think the only time where our fever might not actually sustain is when Razelle takes in too much damage and dies and doesn't get revived quickly enough. But I have yet to see that happen. He is quite tanky with the Labyrinth Swords. So there you go, that's the end of the run. It took us 3 minutes, geez, that's really long. But as you can see, with this one single permanent Light Fever team, we are actually able to complete every single Valentine's daily quest in just one run. So I hope you found this video helpful, and if you do have Christmas Inaho, this is how you can build a permanent fever team. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up if the video proved helpful to you. This has been Free to Play, by the way, and as always, I will see you in the next video.